Hello, Capricorn. I'm Karma. Welcome to my channel, Karma on Deck. I'm guesting on Baba Lao's psychic readings. I work with my psychic one. So we're going to do a couple videos this week and show you what your zodiac looks like for the week. Second week of Mercury retrograde, so we're playing with a little bit of that energy. For me, however, Mercury retrograde is my business, so I've been feeling a little overfloweth. The cup overfloweth. I am feeling it a little bit. A little aggressive energy with overwhelming power surges and then sleep. So let's see what's going on with us, Capricorn, because this is all about me too. Alrighty. First thing that comes up is money. So the Four of Coins is all about gathering money for a project or an event. That's also saving or looking to see where it's coming from. I do see Page of Wands. That's book learning or education. I know me, I'm playing with some astrology lately. That's going to be adding to. Seven of Cups references personal balance. Queen of Cups is all about emotional fulfillment. So as we're coming closer to the Seven of Cups energy, as a human being, what we're doing with that is we're really fleshing out the pockets, so to speak, finding out where the spaces are that need to be filled, making that happen, also standing on our own two feet. Seven of Cups is about internal balance and bringing all these elements in your life back into alignment and getting on your own solid feet, you know, relying on your own counsel, trusting oneself more. Queen of Cups is about mastery of emotion. Queen of Cups is also about having an exchange of love and balance, as well as the Seven of Cups. Wouldn't be surprised if we didn't find the Ten of Cups or a little bit more love going on. I do see the Eight of Swords, which is things being ridiculously overwhelming. This is the fact of which, you know, you can't see the forest for the trees, or you can't see outside of the box, so to speak, just because so many things are going on. We do have the Page of Swords and the Three of Swords. Three of Swords referencing, I always call that my Mercury retrograde card, because it always infers miscommunication or communications going south. I have misspelled words all day or typed them wrong, didn't notice. And the last couple days, I even had a client come over and bring me $20 instead of $80. And then it ended up being, oh, he grabbed the wrong pile. And I said something, both of us were miscommunicating just on an accident. He was picking up some products. So, you know, I was like, at this point, I'm just happy that we're in relationship, that there wasn't a problem out of it, because we love each other. So that's all I care about, is that my relationships stay intact. But the Page of Swords is referencing having a smart attitude, or having a smart mouth or a short temper, and kind of feeling like, you know, you just can't handle one more little thing on the camel's back, so to speak. We do have the King of Swords, and the King of Swords is referencing winning. Even though you've won, you still have things to put in place. Like, you go to war afterward, you still have to realign your government, you still have to put things back in place and reestablish control over a situation. The Moon card being about mapping, being about playing with where you're going. You can't tell where you're going on a map unless you know exactly where you are. So the Moon card is all about that kind of energy. The end result, Four of Swords, is deadlines, pressure, and timing. And the Six of Cups for us is all about actually travel. So for me personally, it's going to be beach soon, within a few weeks. So Six of Cups is celebration and beach. So there's that. Well, I'm Karma. You know where to find me, karmaondeck.com. Subscribe to my channel, Karma on Deck. You can also find me on the banner or in the About More section. I am going to read a card from Divination of the Ancients. This has been my favorite part. So if you like the reading, let me know how I did. Leave a comment. Please let me know where you are in the world and share. If you want to book a one-on-one with me, please go to My Psychic One, mypsychic.one, and visit with Baba Lao. We do have 10 free minutes with Baba Lao when you do register, if you want to go on there. Otherwise, if you want a one-on-one with me, you know how to do it, karmaondeck.com. So let's get to your reading for Divination of the Ancients and see where we sit. First card we're going to pull. Coins, abundance. Now, this is the second time this card came up for Capricorn, because if I remember correctly, a few weeks ago, I said the winning is about to happen, and here we go. And I had somebody reach out and say, I'm still waiting. Well, I am too. However, it's showing that it's coming, and rarely when I say something that strongly does it not happen or come about. So let's take a look here and see what it has to say. So abundance is what coins is all about. And it says, finally, all of your hard work. Now, this is exactly what I read the other week. Like, I want to say 2 weeks ago. So it says, finally, all your hard work, whether it be through sheer hard work, prayer, or positive affirmation, has paid off. Prepare to reap the benefits, for a cornucopia of abundance will be showered upon you. While the abundance may not appear in the form of energy we call money, you will be amazed both by what comes to you and the unique ways in which it appears. Receive the bountiful gifts the universe bestows upon you with gratitude. And indeed I do. This is a great time to start a new business venture, to shake hands on a new partnership, or on a deal that's being offered. Keep your mind focused on the positive. Do not deviate into negative thinking, and you will never go without. Heads or tails, you win, Capricorn. So it says, your desires are coming to fruition. Stay positive and open to new things. No need to focus on money. You'll be supplied with what you need. Be careful what you wish for. Understand the law of attraction. So what's cool about this, though, is opportunities are popping everywhere. I personally was born under Mercury retrograde, so it's kind of like my power time. I know that's not happening for the rest of you, but this is telling you to stay the course. So the incantation for the week says, I understand how I receive. It's how I think, how I perceive. My thoughts and wishes of what I could be manifest in form, come to me. I'm Karma from Karma on Deck, also working for My Psychic One. If you want a one-on-one with me, readings are about $60 for 30 minutes. We'll figure out how you want to do that, whether video, phone, or recording. Give me a shout. Let me know where you're at. And otherwise, I'll see you guys on My Psychic One and next week on the channel. Have a good one.